with you in Namaste. Okay, so let me start out by welcoming you to this lesson, lesson number 4, I believe it is. We're going to be talking about the Taoist and the Buddhist breathing methods. And let me call my assistant for the day and my student for the day, Sifu Andrew. He's been with me for over 20 years, give or take, and just recently officially earned his title as Sifu, so he's my senior student in the program. He's in the system. He's going to be working with me today. So, the Taoist and the Buddhist style breathing methods, you know, styles, methods, techniques, whatever. And we're going to kind of look at some of the some of the contrasts, similarities and differences between those two styles of breathing, okay? So we've gone over the Honi So, the Agni, and the Ah breath. We'll talk a little bit about those as we get into the Taoist and Buddhist style methods. So as you know, Andrew, Buddhist style breathing, the stomach is going to expand, right? And with the Taoist style breathing, the stomach is going to contract. And what we want to understand is, and feel, is what is the difference and similarity between those two methods of breathing? I mean, we've done them, but to really go into the detail and the awareness, and pay attention to, you know, what is actually happening, what are the dynamics of those two types of breathing? And so we're going to first look at the physical effects, and in particular, the physical effects on rooting. Okay. Let me just switch sides here, so yeah, okay, that works. This is better for me. Okay, so what is the effect on rooting? The first thing, and those of you watching the lesson at home, get up, get some exercise in by going through these different things with us, okay, these different little exercises with us. So on the Buddhist style breathing, where the stomach expands, what I get, you know, and each of us is different, so we have to, you know, find what's right for us, right? What I feel is when I, remember the quality of an inhale is based on the quality of the exhale that precedes it, so exhale, stomach is going to expand. Do that along with it, okay? Ready? Okay, now I don't know if you felt it, but what I feel when I do the Buddhist style breath and the stomach expands and you have that sense of the air, you know, going to the abdominal area, what I feel is sinking. Okay? Rooting. Okay, let's try it again. Root at home. Is that related to you?
Yeah,
this feeling
helps, that idea helps.
Yeah, feeling of sinking, okay? And when I release the breath, whether it's an ah breath or, you know, whatever, when I release the breath, I don't get the feeling that inhale was a heavy breath. In other words, we do a heavy breathing. When we let it out, you know, there's this, you know, sense, this tendency to rise back up. But here, when I did the inhale and I felt that, you know, that sinking feeling, when I let it out, I didn't get that feeling of the need to rise back up. I stayed, quote unquote, rooted or sunk or sunk. Does that make sense?
Yeah, so I felt like a second layer of sinking on the exhale.
Right, exactly, yeah. You know, like there was rooting on top of rooting, sinking on top of sinking, sung on top of sung, right? As opposed to the rising back up. Okay. The second thing is I feel a hollow in the abdominal area. Okay, let's do it again. Can you relate?
Yeah.
There's pressure, but it's as though the pressure that I feel inside, right, is simply expanding, you know, this normal area, the condensed, you know, normal place of the organs and whatnot, and pushing that, the walls of that space out so that there is more empty space inside. Now we know it's not empty, right? But it feels like an emptiness inside. Can you just do it again?
Yeah, under pressure.
Yeah, but under a, and not an intense pressure, right? But yes, under a balancing pressure. Okay, so let's do it again. Stay in that position for a while, what I feel is a buoyancy up top. Like this has become more solid, you know, again, not exaggerated, but more solid. And up top, you know those half balls that they have in the gym, right?
Oh yeah.
The balance balls?
Yeah.
Okay. So it feels like my upper body is sitting on one of those balance balls. And so it can, you know, move while this remains, you know, rooted, but remains stable with good structure. Okay. So this floating feeling, let's try it. Come on, work with us. Let's do this. Can you relate?
Yeah.
So that rooting and the pressure that we feel in the abdominal area with the Buddha style breath does not translate into tension that permeates the whole body. Mm-hmm. Okay. And even the strengthening of the lower structure is not from tension. It's just from sinking the mass, sinking the weight, okay? Just a sinking. Make sense?
Make sense
at home? Okay, also, if not, make comments, questions below, and I will try to respond in one of our future videos, okay? All right. So this buoyancy of the upper body. The last piece is, on, you know, in terms of these four comparisons, the internal pressure. Okay. So yes, there is some internal pressure there, but it's very, very light. Right? It's the kind of pressure that could send a strike to the abdomen, just moving through that space, right, and touching, you know, various organs, right? So that's the hollowness, that's, you know, there's open paths in there, right? So for me, the only way to seal that off would be to add more pressure and to add more muscular tension, more Li, muscle control, okay? With the consciousness that would bring more Qi into the area, right? So, the Buddha style breath. Now there's this emptiness that I feel very vulnerable, okay? But if I more pressure and muscle, okay, I feel those strikes on the surface, but I don't feel any penetration of the strike, okay? So in terms of internal pressure from a defensive standpoint, right, you have to add pressure to the hollow and put a shield in front of it. And the chi part is for that shield to be distributed in such a way that chi supports the muscles.
Okay.
To strengthen the, it's like you put up a wall, right, to stop something from coming from the other side. You put up a wall and then you put bracing into the ground, supporting the upper third of the wall to give it that extra strength. Okay. That's the role that the chi is playing to support Li, the muscles.
Okay.
Make sense?
That does. Okay. Yeah, that helps. Kind of like the difference, I was imagining like a inflated balloon, you know, like kind of that emptiness, but there's pressure on the walls. But then that tightening it up is like, you know, grabbing an end of it
and squeezing,
squeezing
right.
It, making it.
Right. Good analogy. Good analogy. Okay.
Thanks.
All right, yes. Okay. One more piece of that. Think about what happens when, or feel what happens with the spine in the lower lumbar area, in the area of what Ming Men point on. That's the meridian, Ming Men, down in the lower part of the spine, in the lumbar area, right? Pretty much across from the navel, right? So when we do the Buddhist style breath, what I feel is very slight, but a tendency for pressure, a pull to be placed on the spine, pulling the spine this way, toward the front. See if you feel that. Yeah. And then when you release the breath, you can feel it, the spine kind of come back into its quote-unquote normal alignment, for normal for you. Does that make sense?
Yeah, I feel that, yes.
Okay.
That does make sense.
Okay, let's look at the Taoist style.